This is Brachot Daf Dalet Amud Bet in the sugya of Smichat Geula Latfila Tosfot Dibor Marchil D'Amar Rav Yochanan Izehu Ben HaOlam Haba. Rav Yochanan says, who is a person who is meritorious of Olam Haba? Is someone v'chulei, someone who is somech Geula Latfila at Arvit. Tosfot begins by raising a problem. V'anu she'omrim yiru einenu. We say the paragraph of Yeruah, the bracha of Yeruah Einenu, before, after Hashivenu, before Shmon Esrei Amariv, the psukim achirim achar Hashivenu, and other psukim, the psukim of Baruch Hashem Leolam Amen V'Amen. How do we say all these psukim and bracha, extra bracha, if you're not supposed to interrupt between Geula and Tefillah other than Hashivenu? Nirat also it says it appears. Since the Chachamim were metaken to say these things, is an extension of Geula and is not a hefsek between the Geula and the Tefillah. Titekinu lomar zeh, because they made this takana, shebetoch kach yitpaleo chavero gamahu, because of this is a takana for the benefit of Tefillah, that because of your saying Baruch Hashem le'olam, your friends will be able to daven as well. V'lo yelechem yivin haKnesset, and will not leave early from the Beit Knesset. Ashigmar kol echad tefilaso. The purpose of Baruch Hashem liolam amen v'amen is for the benefit of the davening. It's a takanas chachamim, and since it's a takana, came into tekinu loy. It's not an interruption. It's part of the davening itself. The Gam, and furthermore, Yesh Ba'osam Psukim Yudchet Askaros. In those Psukim, there's 18 mentions of God's name. Keneged Yudchet Bracho to Shmona Esrei. Corresponding to the Shmona Esrei. So Baruch Hashem Li'olam is actually somewhat connected to Shmona Esrei. Va'agav She'tiknu Lomar Osam Psukim Tiknu Lomar Chasima Shel Yeru Einenu. And once they added the Psukim, they added also in concluding Bracha of Yeru Einenu. So Tosfot says that these interruptions are not really a problem. They're all part and parcel of the Takanas of the Chachamim. The Halacha to Rabbi Yochanan. And Tosfot paskins that we follow Rabbi Yochanan, the Braisa Misayei Alei, because the Braisa supports him. Like the Gemara explained, the V'chein Pasak Halachos Gedolos, and the Halachos Gedolos paskins like Rabbi Yochanan as well. V'imkein, and if so, therefore, yesh li zaher, we should be careful, shalola saper ben geula da'arvit l'shmon esrei. Therefore, we shouldn't talk in between the geula and shmon esrei, other than the things that we're supposed to say as part of the takana of the chachamim. Mihu, however, b'seder of Amram, in the siddur, the order of the davening that Rav Amram Gon prepared, Piresh, he explains, Masha Anu Omrim Kaddish, Ben Geula the Tefillah, that which we say Kaddish, between Geula and Tefillah, and Arvit, Lashmu'inan tells us, the Lo Ba'inan Mismach Geula the Arvit the Tefillah. The Kaddish symbolizes the fact that there is no requirement of Smicha Geula Tefillah at night, and we don't pass like Rabbi Yochanan, Mishum, and the reason is the tefillah arvit rishud, because the marv tefillah is optional from to begin with. How can it be that we're required, obligated to do smicha kula tefillah if we're not obligated to say tefillah at all? The loni hira, but Tosfot doesn't accept Rav Amram. The imkain, because if that would be the case, Rav Yochanan Tzvira lay tefillat arvit chova, that would mean that that analysis assumes that Rav Yochanan would believe that arvit is a chova, the pluktahi, the Rav Yochanan halachik Rav Yochanan. And if it's a debate between Rav and Rav Yochanan, Rav is the one who believes Marv is Rishut, and Rav Yochanan will be saying here chova, so we should paskin like Rav Yochanan. So Tosfot doesn't think that there's a factor, the Marav Rishut issue. V'nachol lahachmir v'lizayir milisaber ben asayim, and therefore, we should be careful not to talk between Geula and Tefillah. V'itema, and if you'll ask, Kasha Hilchata Hilchata, that's a contradiction in the Psak Halacha, to Kaimalan Tfilat Arvit Rashut, because we paskin and it's Rashut, V'hacha paskin on Rabbi Yochanan Tzarech, and here we paskin like Rabbi Yochanan, that you need to do Sichat Kulal Tfilat Tzarech Lomar, Da'afilu Usover Rabbi Yochanan Kerav, Ta'amar Rashut, Mikol Mako Mechayev Lismuch. It's not a contradiction. It can be the Marav is Rashut, but nevertheless, when you dali Marav, you're required to connect it to Gula. In Kain, Gamlonu Yesh Lismuch, therefore we also should do Smichat Gula Tfila and Marav, even though it's Rashut, but if you're davening Marav, you must do Smichat Gula Tfila.